Hi, I'm Troy Suttle with Mersive Technologies, and today we're going to take a look at how to use your Solstice room with Microsoft Teams running on a user's laptop to create a new class of Bring Your Own Meeting room system. And as we'll see in the demo, this actually has some advantages over traditional Teams room systems. So let's jump into it. I'm a user, I walk into the room, I want to host my Teams meeting with the combination of other people in the room as well as remote participants. To get started, all I need to do is enter the Solstice screen key on my device. Now, I already have the Solstice application installed on this device. So what that means is that I can just click the system tray and enter the screen key. For users that don't have the application installed, they will need to download it, and they can do so in one of two ways. They can go to mersive.com/download, or they can just follow instructions on the welcome screen. Additionally, Mersive provides the ability for IT administrators to push out the Solstice application to all of their devices. That option is also available via mersive.com/download. So before I start the demo, I want to talk for a second about what's in the room. So I'm again the meeting host. I've walked into the room with my device. In the room, there's a Solstice pod. It's connected to the display by HDMI. It's connected by USB to the room audio and video peripheral. In this case, it's a Logitech meetup. And then the Solstice pod is also on the local Wi-Fi and Ethernet network. And my device is connected to that same network, the local in-room Wi-Fi. So now, in a single step, I can start the meeting. And when I enter the screen key, Solstice is going to connect all the technology and get the Teams meeting started. So I'll enter the screen key, and a few things happen. So Solstice automatically finds the calendar invite, finds the Teams meeting link in the calendar invite, and launches that meeting. It automatically shares my display to the room display. So it shares my laptop desktop here to the room display. I'll go ahead and hit join. And then the third thing that Solstice does is it gives me access from my device to the room audio and video peripherals. So in this case, again, the Logitech meetup. Looks like we've got Kira on the other end. Hi, Kira. You know, now from here, it's just a normal Teams meeting. And I, as the meeting host, can run the meeting from my laptop. And everyone in the room can be seen and can also see the remote participants. So from here, maybe I want to share some content. Now, one important thing to note when content sharing is that I want to select screen 2 as what I share. And in doing so, shares out the room display instead of just my desktop. And that becomes important when other users in the room want to share and contribute content in the meeting. So maybe we start the meeting with just slides from my desktop. We can look through a few of these car slides, but then, you know, maybe another participant in the meeting brings their phone in and has some images that they think might help us come to a decision. So that user just connects by via Solstice app, or one of the other ways that Solstice lets you share, such as AirPlay or Miracast. And from here, they can share content as well. So I'll share some other car images from this phone to maybe help us figure out what we want to do in this meeting. So now there's three content sources shared from two different user devices, and all of that is being shared out via Teams to the remote participants. So they can see and hear everything that's happening in the room as if they were in the room as well, including all the content. And, you know, Solstice doesn't stop there. It also allows users to arrange content. Maybe if we want to focus on this image for a moment, discuss that, we can do so, you know, put it back. It also allows users to kind of annotate and mark up and highlight content through our mobile app. So maybe that's an image we want to start with, or maybe I want to draw everyone's attention to this, image in the upper left corner. All that can be done through Solstice, and all that becomes visible to the remote participants. So it enhances the collaboration experience when using your conferencing applications like Teams. So that's a quick run through of how Solstice works with Microsoft Teams. To end the meeting, I simply end the Teams call, and then when I'm ready, I will also disconnect from the display in the room. And that's all we need to do to end the meeting, and then the second user would also disconnect when they're ready. So that's how to use Solstice with Microsoft Teams running on a laptop to level the playing field between on-site and remote collaborators and really enhance the collaboration experience. As I mentioned, it's got some advantages over traditional Teams rooms. One of those advantages is that it's agnostic. So today we looked at how to use Solstice with Teams, but Solstice also works with other major conferencing services, including Zoom, WebEx, and the other and others. And beyond the agnosticism, Solstice is also a combination of more collaborative, as we've discussed, and it's a completely touchless solution. So there's no room infrastructure that I physically engage with as a user. I engage the room technology through my device, which is both more hygienic, but it also allows us to offer the Solstice as a room system at a lower cost. And that makes the solution more scalable to additional spaces, even meeting spaces that maybe have low budgets. And I think that will become very important as more and more meeting spaces require conferencing solutions with more folks working remotely than ever before. So thank you for joining us today. This has been a demo of how to use Solstice with Microsoft Teams. To learn more, you can visit mersive.com/conference.